हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज़ इन कॉन्टिन्यूशन विद माई प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑन साइकेडेल्स वेयर आई एक्सप्लेन टू यू जनरल करेक्टर क्लासिफिकेशन अनाटॉमी एंड मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ साइकेडेल्स एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विद यू रिप्रोडक्शन एज वेल एज इकोनॉमिक इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ साइकेडेल्स. स्टूडेंट्स, साइकेड रिप्रोड्यूस बोथ वेजिटेटिवली एंड सेक्शुअली. Vegetative reproduction is by means of bulbils. They dwell in services of the scale leaves and leaf bases at the basal part of old stem and produce new plant on detachment. Here you can see bulbils which arises at the leaf bases or the scale leaves. And in second image you can see that they give rise to new plant. Students, sexual reproduction occur with the help of pollen grains and seeds. Cycad produce pollen and seeds in cones. Cone develop at the apex of the stem. All cycads are dioecious, means they produce either male cones or seed cones on separate plant, as you can see in these images. Here is image of Ceratozoemia mexicana, and you can see mega and microstrobilus of the Ceratozoemia mexicana. Next is male cone. Students, male cones are terminal except macrozoemia, where they arises in the axil of the leaf. They are compact, bearing central axis, having numerous spirally arranged microsporophylls, as you can see in these images. They have a prominent central axis and bear microsporophylls which are arranged spirally on the cone axis. Microsporophylls are simple conical structure with distinct fertile and sterile region, distal and produced to single spinous projection in Cycas thion macrozoemia, two projection in Ceratozoemia, and projections are absent in Zoemia. Microsporangia are present on the abaxial or lower surface. They appear as a mass but in distinct group of one and more. These groups are called sorae and their number varies up to 1000. Sporangia dioecious with longitudinal slit and their development is eusporangiate type, means they develop from a group of initial. Students, here you can clearly see microstrobilus or male cone, and here is image of microsporophyll. You know very well leaf bearing spore are called sporophyll, and when they bear microspore they are called as microsporophyll. They further bear microsporangia on their lower surface and they occur in groups, so they are called as sorae. Here is image of Zoemia showing microstrobilus. Male cone are also single with each microsporophyll modified leaf forming a stalked peltate structure. Here you can see stalked or peltate structure of the Zoemia bearing microsporangia. Here is sperm of the Zoemia. Students, in this image you can see Zoemia furfuracea and Zoemia pumilia bearing cones. A microsporangium has massive cell wall made up of several layers of cell. Hypodermal cell is with microsporangial initial, give rise to wall and sporogenous cells. Sporogenous cell then further differentiated to outer single layer tapetum and microspore or pollen grain arranged in tetrads. Pollen grains are pioneer of male gametophyte. Each microspore is with two spore coat, that is outer exine and inner intine, which is thin along the top and bottom of the spore and thick along the sides of the microspore. So spore has distinct upper and lower end. There is big centrally located nucleus and dense cytoplasm. Microspores germinate within the microsporangium, that is called precocious germination, as in heterospore. Students, here you can see very clearly cone axis bearing microsporophyll, and each microsporophyll have lower fertile region and upper sterile region, that is known as apophysis, and microsporangium are present at the abaxial side, and each microsporangium has a wall of microsporangium tapetum and microspores. And these microspores are arranged in a group of four. After germination, they will form sperm. You can see they are multiflagellate. Students, nucleus divide to form small prothelial cell and large sister cell with generative cell and a tube nucleus. So at this three cell stage, semi-germinated microspore releases from the microsporangium. And this is important question for your examination. Oftenly asked as, at which cell stage microspore shed from the microsporangium? And the answer is three cell stage. Pollination is by wind, means anemophilous type of pollination takes place. Pollen pull to pollen chamber. Three-celled microspore germinate on nucellus. Each pollen is with pollen tube, which penetrate nucellus tissue along sides of the pollen chamber. Generative cell is with stalk cell, that is small, compact with prothelial cell and body cell, having two spermatozoids which are multiflagellate, as you can see in this image. In first image, you can see three cell stages of the pollen grain and develop to form sperms which are multiflagellated. Students, Cycadaceae male cone and cataphylls show synapomorphy, means they show ancestor characters. Cataphylls are the leaf and the male cone are modified leaf-bearing microspore. And this synapomorphy is present in Cycas titungensis, that is native to Taiwan. Students, many cycads are pollinated by insect. Only a few cycad species studied and beavils, the oldest known bee genus Trigona, is responsible for the insect pollination. Usually pollinator mate and lay egg within female cone. All cones except Stengaria produce heat, thought to volatilize pollinator attachments. Hence, insect pollinations may predate flowering plants, Trigona weevils. Next is female cone. Students, all living genera except Cycas bear compact female cones, that is megasporophyll, arranged compactly around the central axis, and they are also terminate. Here is Thoon female cone. Growth continue as another bud appear near base of the female cone, which pushes earlier cone to the one side, thus show sympodial growth. In Cycas, cones are spirally arranged in microsporophylls. They alternate with cataphylls and foliose leaves. Loose megasporangiate zone are very primitive with monopodial growth, that is apical growth, which continues. Usually one cone at the apex, sometimes two may appear. Cone size varies. In Thoon, 2 feet. In Macrosemia, they are 75 cm long, and in Pygemia, they are 2 cm, that is smallest. Megasporophylls have distal striae laminate portion plus stalk-like portion and bear 2 to 3 ovules with micropyles toward cone axis. The megasporophylls of the Cycas is leaf-like with ovules at the base. The enlarged one has been fertilized and is developing into seed. So you can see here loosely arranged female cone of the Cycas, and you can clearly see in this image ovule are present at the basal portion of the megasporophyll. Cycas megasporophyll cone are most primitive. They show leaf like nature, as you can see in these images. According to one view, the course of evolution is laminate and distal part reduced with number and size of ovule. Strobiliferous cycads have 2 to 3 ovules. Their distal part is laminate but not leaf-like and never peltate. Each stage is advanced, having peltate megasporophyll as in Jamia and Macrosemia with 2. Ovules foliar in origin and cycad are phyllospermous, means they arises from the leaf. Another view is megasporophyll peltate are primitive, with open female organs of the Cycas shows peltate sporophylls regarded as a sporangiophores instead of sporophylls. So ovules are calling in origin and cycad are stachyospermous, means they arises from the stem. Here you can see साइकस रेबुलेटा बियरिंग फीमेल कोन, साइकस सर्सिनेलस बियरिंग फीमेल कोन एंड साइकस नॉर्बियाना बियरिंग ओव्यूल्स. नेक्स्ट इज ओव्यूल. स्टूडेंट्स, ओव्यूल इज ससाइल एज यू कैन सी इन दिस इमेज, दैट इज विदाउट स्टॉक. एट मेच्योरिटी 1/3 ऑफ न्यूसिलस इज फ्री फ्रॉम इंटेगुमेंट एट द माइक्रोपाइलर एंड. न्यूसिलस इज पैनकामेटस विथ सब एपिडर्मल सेल. इंटेगुमेंट इज विथ 3 रीजन, आउटर एंड इनर फ्लैशी एंड मिडल स्टोनी. न्यूसिलस इज पैनकामेटस विथ सब एपिडर्मल सेल्स. मेगास्पोर मदर सेल इज विथ 4 मेगास्पोर, 3 जनरेट टूअर्ड द माइक्रोपाइलर रीजन एंड 1 इज फंक्शनल. स्टूडेंट, हेयर यू कैन सी एंड लार्ज इमेज ऑफ द ओब्यूल एंड यू कैन सी एट द माइक्रोपाइलर एंड ओब्यूल इज विदाउट इंटेगुमेंट एंड यू कैन सी हेयर पॉलन चैम्बर व्यर पॉलन ग्रेन्स टेक रेस्ट एंड आर्चिगोनियल चैम्बर व्यर आर्चिगोनिया आर देयर. देयर इज न्यूसिलस एंड फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो सी इनर एंड आउटर फ्लैशी लेयर एंड मिडल स्टोनी लेयर एंड थ्रेड लेग स्ट्रक्चर आर वेस्कुलर सप्लाई टू द ओब्यूल. ईच मेगास्पोर एनलार्ज एंड न्यूक्लियर डिवाइड अबाउट 1000 टाइम्स. बॉल फॉर्मेशन अकर फ्रॉम पेरिफेरी टू सेंटर. लेटर सेलुलर मास इज द फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट एज यू कैन सी इन दिस इमेज. एज इट डेवलप न्यूसिलस एक्सटेंड एपिकली फॉर्मिंग सॉलिड न्यूसिलर वीक दैट एक्सटेंड इन टू माइक्रोपाइल. ईच आर्चिगोनियल इनिशियल अपियर एट द माइक्रोपाइलर रीजन ऑफ द फीमेल प्रोथेलस. ऑल डेवलप टू आर्चिगोनिया. ईच इनिशियल फ्रॉम आउटर नेक्सल प्रोड्यूस 2 नेक्सल्स एंड इनर सेंट्रल सेल. एनलार्ज बिफोर फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड डिवाइड टू प्रोड्यूस स्मॉल वेंट्रल कैनाल सेल एंड अ मासिव एग सेल. न्यूसिलस सेल फॉर्म अ जैकेट लेयर बिफोर फर्टिलाइजेशन. न्यूसिलस टिश्यू सेपरेट पॉलन चैम्बर. 3 सेल स्पोर एंटर आर्चिगोनियल चैम्बर. वेंट्रल कैनाल सेल डीजनरेट एंड फर्टिलाइजेशन रिजल्ट इन टू जाइगोट. स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो वेरी वेल ऑल दीज प्रोसेसेस ऑफ द फर्टिलाइजेशन. पॉलीएम्ब्रियोनी में अक्कर एज मेनी आर्चिगोनिया गॉट फर्टिलाइज. वट वन गेट मेच्योरिटी अदर डी जनरेट द इंटेगुमेंट फॉर्म सीड कोट. स्टूडेंट, हेयर यू कैन सी स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द सीड एंड क्लोज बाय द वेल डेवलप्ड सीड कोट और इंटेगुमेंट्स. नेक्स्ट इज इकोनॉमिक इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ साइकेड्स. स्टूडेंट्स, साइकस इज यूज एज अ सोर्स ऑफ फूड इन जापान, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, साउथ ईस्ट एशिया, सदर्न एंड ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया एंड सम अदर कंट्रीज. इट इज़ यूज इन द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ स्टार्च एंड अल्कोहलिक ड्रिंक. द स्टार्च एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम इट्स स्टेम इज कॉल्ड सागो. फॉर प्रिपेरिंग सागो द बार्क ऑफ द ट्रंक इज रिमूव एंड द ट्रंक इज कट इन टू थीन डिशेज. दीज आर ड्राइड, ग्राउंड एंड पेस्ट इज प्रिपेयर्ड बाई एडिंग वाटर. एक्सेस ऑफ वाटर इज एडिड एंड द पेस्ट इज लेफ्ट फॉर सम टाइम इन अ स्टैंड स्टिल पोजिशन. The starch settles down and clear upper liquid is drained off. Between the board, the starch is rolled. This gives the starch a characteristic round shape. It is finally dried and sold as a sago in the market. Here is kheer made up of sago. Students, this is the sago or sabudana which is eaten during fast. In Japan, seeds and stem of Cycas rebulata are used for preparing wine. The juice obtained from young leaves of the Cycas sarsinellus is used in skin diseases, vomiting of blood and stomach disorder. The decoction of the young red seeds of Cycas sarsinellus is used as a purgative and emetic to relieve the headache, giddiness and sore throat. The seeds of Cycas rebulata are prepared in the form of tincture and used. Cycas rebulata and Cycas sarsinellus plant are often grown for ornamental purposes in the various parts of the world. They are also sold at high cost. The wood of the Cycas rebulata is used for preparing small boxes and dishes. Cycas leaves, being very large, are used for preparing baskets, mat, etc., as you can see in this image. Cycas sarsinellus seeds are used as a fish poison. Babrias yielding cycad. A beverage is prepared from the pitch of Encephalotoris by some tribal people of Central Africa. Edible cycads. Underground tuberous stem of Bovinia spectabilis are cooked and eaten by some native people of Queensland. Bread is prepared from the starch of Encephalotoris, Macrozemia and Jamia. Boiled seed of Dune, Meze are also used for making bread. The kernels of the Dune Adule are roasted and eaten with paste by certain tribal people. The seeds of Phalaretus yield a gum which is eaten by people where this plant grows. Hats, mats, baskets and several other similar articles are prepared from the leaves of Encephalotus in some African countries. Hairs obtained from the leaf pieces of Macrozemia are used as a stuffing fiber. Medicinal uses. A decoction prepared from seed of Dune Adule is used by the Mexicans for treating neuralgia. Oil from cycads. Seeds of the Macrozemia yield an oil used as a palm oil by some native people. Poisonous cycad. Some poisonous substances have been reported in the leaves of Macrozemia. Animals eating leaves of this cycad. Many show some symptoms similar to rickettsias. Starch yielding cycads. Sago starch or arrowroot is obtained from the seeds and stem of the Macrozemia, Jamia and Encephalotus. This is used in laundering and several other purposes. So students, that's all about the reproduction and economic importance of cycadales. I hope you understood this topic. Thank you for listening.